Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn 9 super useful time-saving tricks in PowerPoint, and these tricks are mainly for beginners in PowerPoint. But before I share with you those time-saving tricks, let me remind you that one of the nicest ways to save some time in learning PowerPoint is by subscribing to this channel. So please head over to Presentation Process channel page and hit the subscribe button. Did you do it? Great. Let us go to the 9 super useful time-saving tricks. The first trick is something that even experienced PowerPoint users don't know. The trick is to use double-click to select a word and to triple-click to select a paragraph. Let me show you what I mean by this. Here is a slide with some text. Let me show you how to double-click to select any word. I go here, double-click, and that word is selected. If I want to select this one, I double-click. This one, I double-click. Can you see here? It's very easy to select a word by double-clicking on it. The reason why this is helpful is many times we tend to over-select or under-select whenever we use a simple cursor. Just by double-clicking, we would be able to select a word very accurately. The next thing that many people don't know is it's possible to select the entire paragraph by just triple clicking. For example, let me go here, click, 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 and that is it. I have my entire paragraph selected. Let me go here, click, 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 and that is it. Click, 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 click. Yeah, can you see here? It's a very simple thing. So double click to select a word and triple click to select a paragraph. The next trick is to hold Control Shift to copy on a straight line. Let us say I want to make a copy of this circle and place it over here. Many of the beginners would first select this and then go to copy and then right click and then paste again, and then they try to place it somewhere and then they wonder if they have actually placed it correctly or not, and then they have to use arrange, and there is a lot of rigmarole that goes behind copying an item on a straight line. Let me show you how easy it is to copy an item by holding Control and Shift simultaneously while you select the item and move it to its new place. Let me show you how it is done. I've got my Control button and Shift button pressed now. I'm going to select this item, and as you can see here, there is a straight line guide that tells me that the movement is straight and I can leave my cursor, and there I have a copy. You don't have to worry about the alignment when you use this method. It saves you a lot of time. Similarly, if I want to make a copy of this triangle and place it vertically down, I can do so while holding the Control and Shift button. I'm going to move this triangle down, and you can see even if I try to move it on either sides, it will not happen. The movement will only happen straight, and that is because we are holding Control and Shift. And once we are happy with the location, I just leave my cursor and the copy is made. This saves you a lot of time in copying and arranging items on a slide. The next useful trick is to use Control D for smart copying. Even experienced presenters are not fully aware of the real power of Control D. To give you an idea of the smart copying possible with Control D, let me show you that this grid was created using Control D in a matter of seconds. Let me show you how it is done. I'm going to delete this. Let us say I want to create a straight line like this, and then I want to make a copy of this. The first time around, I press Control D, and that creates a duplicate, and I'm going to place this somewhere over here. This is the distance between the lines I want to keep as I make more copies here. All I need to do, since I've already used Control D and positioned this new object wherever I wanted, when I press Control D again, you can see that the new copy is made right below with the same distance from the original object. So I can keep hitting Control D over and over, and you can see that I've got sufficient number of these horizontal lines in place. The same way, if I have to draw a vertical line like so, and then I can press Control D and keep this somewhere over here, which means that this is the distance that I want to maintain from here on. And when I use Control D, while holding Control button down, I keep hitting D over and over again, and that allows me to complete the grid in a matter of seconds. Can you see here? This can really be of help when you want to create your bullet point list or arrange items one below the other in equal distance. Use it and you'll be surprised at how handy this trick is. The next trick is to use autocorrect option to type fast with accuracy. Take a look at this text. It says, Quevenzhané Wallace was nominated for Oscar. And we have got the name Quevenzhané written quite a few times in the paragraph. Now, when you have to write some difficult names like this over and over, it can be a big pain, not only in terms of the time it takes, but also in the possibilities of making spelling mistakes. When you use autocorrect option, you can really save on a lot of time and agony while typing words that have a lot of names like this, especially the complex names like this. The way you use the trick is, first you type out the correct spelling once, and then you select that particular word. Yeah, you can see that I have really struggled here. So I'm going to use my regular trick, which is to double click on this, and I have selected that word. Now, I'm going to press Ctrl C, which is the shortcut for copy, and then let me go to File, go to Options, go to Proofing, and go to Autocorrect Options, and here I'm going to say replace, say any string of letters, like say QQ, and you want to replace that with the word that you've already copied. I'm going to press Ctrl V to paste it back, and you can see that every time I type QQ, it automatically gets replaced by Quevenzhané. I'm going to say add, and I'm going to say OK, and I'm going to say OK here. Now, let me use the text box tool and write QQ and press spacebar, and you can see that Quevenzhané is automatically typed. As I mentioned earlier, this can be a real time saver when you want to write a lot of text with complex names. The next useful trick is to use crop to aspect ratio for full page photos. Using full page photos is now the rage. But then, whenever you insert photos on a slide, their dimensions don't really match the dimensions of your slide. So how do you crop these pictures exactly to match the dimensions of your slide? It's very simple. First, you select the picture, go to the Format tab of PowerPoint Ribbon, and go to the Crop tool here. Don't click on the crop icon. Click on the small downward arrow here, and that opens up a menu. Go to aspect ratio and you select the aspect ratio of the PowerPoint file that you're working on. If you're working on the newer versions, by default, you must be using 16:9 aspect ratio. If you're using the older versions of PowerPoint, then you might be using 4:3 aspect ratio. Whatever is your aspect ratio, you can choose either 4:3 or 16:9. And in this case, I'm going to use 16:9. And you can see that PowerPoint automatically does all the calculation and does the cropping exactly to the way that you want. I'm going to click outside. And now I'm going to place this so that the photo corresponds to the top left corner of my slide. And then I'm going to just extend this so that it covers the entire slide end to end. And this is a big time saver, especially when you want to create designer type of PowerPoint slides. The sixth time saving trick is to use log drawing mode to use an auto shape multiple times. Let me show you what I mean by this. Let us say I have made these shapes to represent an organizational chart. Now, I need to connect them using an elbow connector. For this, I need to first go to Auto Shapes Gallery and then look for the right tool and then locate it. And you can see that this is the tool that I want called Elbow Arrow. I'm going to click on it and then I'm going to connect this to this. Now, once again, let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery. Once again, find the right tool again and then click on it and then come back and use it. And as you can see, I need to go back to Auto Shapes Gallery over and over to complete this diagram, and that can be quite a painful process. Now, let me show you how you can save a lot of time and frustration by locking that particular auto shape. First, let me select these items and I'm going to delete it, and I'm going to show you how to use the log drawing mode to save time. So let us go here. You go to the Auto Shapes Gallery once, you find the tool that you want once, and once you are happy with the tool, you right click and go to lock drawing mode option. Now you can see that your cursor is changed to that particular tool, which means I can use this to connect these two boxes. And now my cursor still has the same tool in place. So once again, I'm going to use this to connect these I'm going to use this to connect this. And then I'm going to click on this and click on this, and I've connected this. Can you see here? I am using the same tool over and over again, and I have not gone back to my AutoShapes gallery again. And that saves a lot of time, especially when you want to create a flow chart or an organizational chart. Now, once you've finished drawing, then you can go to AutoShapes gallery and click on the same tool, and now you reclaim your cursor back. This trick can really save you a lot of time. The seventh useful time-saving trick is to place all your frequently used tools in Quick Access Toolbar. This is a very simple thing to do, especially in the way that I'm about to suggest to you. Many presenters spend way too much time in placing a tool in Quick Access Toolbar. Let me show you how easy it is. Let us say I want to use something like slide size. So let me go to design and go to the slide size. And this is the tool that I want to keep in my Quick Access Toolbar. By the way, Quick Access Toolbar is what you see here, either above or below PowerPoint ribbon, so that you can access those tools very easily at the click of a button. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let us say I want to move this over here. All I need to do is to right click, and it says add to Quick Access Toolbar, and there it is. Now, if I want to change my slide size, I don't really have to go every time to design and then search for that particular tool. I can find that tool right here. Now, if I don't want that anymore, all I need to do is to right click on this and click on remove from Quick Access Toolbar, and it is removed. So it is that easy to place any tool onto Quick Access Toolbar and to remove it. So a smart thing for you to do is to go to the various tabs in PowerPoint ribbon and see the tools that you would be using quite frequently, and then place them on Quick Access Toolbar so that you can save time in searching for those tools over and over again. The next useful time-saving trick in PowerPoint is to use Tell Me What You Want To Do tool to find a tool fast. Now, that is a lot of tools here, but then let me show you what I mean by this. Many presenters are not aware that there is an option here called Tell Me What You Want To Do, which can be always accessed quite easily by using the shortcut called Alt-Q. This can be a big time saver. Let me say I want to find the option for Custom Slideshow. If I don't remember the exact location of the tool offhand, then I may have to spend a lot of time going from tab to tab locating that tool. However, when you know that there is this useful tool available here called Tell Me, all you need to do is to write custom, and even before you complete your sentence, you can actually find the tool that you want, and you click and you would be able to get whatever you want very quickly. Let me do that again. Let us say I want to find format background. So I go here and say format, and before I finish typing, I have format background available and I can click it and access it. Now, for those of you who are using Office 365 subscription, you can even do some preliminary research on your subject right within PowerPoint using the Tell Me option. For example, let me do some research on something like, say, lung cancer. I go here and ask for smart lookup on lung cancer. I click on that option, and PowerPoint or Bing does the search for me, and it produces this result. Here I can see a Wikipedia article on lung cancer. I can click on this and go directly to that article. These are the web search results on lung cancer. Can you see here that PowerPoint has gone way beyond being a simple presentation tool? It is now your research tool as well. Now, the final useful time-saving trick is to use Control Tab to switch between PowerPoint windows. Now, at this point, I'm using three different presentations. Can you see here? This is one presentation, this is another presentation, and this is a third presentation. If I want to switch between the various windows of PowerPoint, all I need to do is to use Control Tab. Can you see here? I move to the next presentation. Again, Control Tab, another presentation. Control Tab, another presentation. So it is that easy for me to switch between the various presentation views by using Control Tab shortcut. I'm sure you already know that if you want to move between the various programs, you can always use Alt Tab option. For example, when I use Alt Tab, I get this window where all the things that I have open are all seen, and all I need to do is to use Tab to go from one to the next. Like for example, this is the recording that is happening right now in Camtasia. I can go to this view, this view, this view. Now, when I just take my hand off, I go to that specific window that I want to open. Anyway, now that we are here, if you are somebody who is interested to know way more tricks than the ones that I had shown you in this video, then Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program can be a useful resource for you. This program is arguably the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training available online. The kind of PowerPoint tips and tricks that I share in this program are not found in any book or courses anywhere online. I will leave a link to Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program in the description box below the video. You can click on the link and you can always find more details about this program. If you want to take a look at our premium PowerPoint templates, you can always go to our site presentationprocess.com and go to PowerPoint Templates Packs option, and there you would be able to find all the premium PowerPoint templates that we have. For example, you can find more details about our comprehensive all-in-one bundle and various other useful PowerPoint templates bundles available on our site. So go ahead, take a look at the various options available. I will leave a link to this page in the description box below the video as well. And finally, if you want to register for our free presentation process membership, it is quite easy. You would be able to get access to a number of useful mini courses and downloadable resources entirely for free when you become our free presentation process member. All you need to do is to click on the link here, which will take you to the registration page where you can sign up for our presentation process free membership. If you're someone who is truly interested in taking your PowerPoint game to the next level, then presentation process free membership can be a nice starting point. So click on the link here, and I will see you inside.